Okay, I don't think we need to sneak. It's funny, I thought I saw that move. That was weird. We need to run around here. Right. You stand again before the four stone panels. Perform the sign of the tide on the hidden carving. You curl your hand as Kowtow had done and position position it over the carving of the wave. Then, using your other hand, you trace the arc of the crescent with your index and little fingers. Well, I didn't even specifically say he did that. A heavy rumble stirs the ground, and from all around you comes the sound of rushing water. We better go. Oh, what's all this? We can just walk on this? Alrighty then.
I'll see what I can find.
I guess sneaking? I don't know. Well, we've been here. Now what do we do? We haven't gone in there though. Oh, I know where we are. This is where that gate was, I think? Wait. No, the gate was here. This gate was closed. That, I don't know what's here. Back up. Oh, this is where we flooded here. Embedded in this deep semicircular slab is what looks to be a vessel for the sprinkling of holy water. In this context, however, it looks more like a lever. There are images engraved on the wall behind it. One of a rising wave, one of an open gate. Well, number one drowns everybody. Number two lets them free. I'm guessing. Point the object toward the open gate. In the distance, you hear the mechanical snap of rusted locks and the groan of iron hinges. And then... I've let all the maniacs free. What? Stop them! Our brethren! Do not harm them! Echoing voices reach your ears. The words are unintelligible, but you can make out laughter, crying, and tears. Now, the guy did say they're old. They really can't cause much damage. I'd rather let them free, if do anything, than drown them. It's horrible. Soon after, shouts of alarm resonate in the distance. With a click, the machine releases its hold on a strange rod. You pack the vessel away.
Let's hope we don't run into any of them on the way out.
We might. I have Andra's witness in my possession. It may be what I need to access the reliquary. Okay, good. We needed it anyway. Sweet. Where is it? And what does it look like? Is it... probably a quest item in stash, I guess, right? Andra's witness. The ritual of sprinkling holy water is one of the most important traditions in the Andrite Church. For Andra's followers, it signifies not only a sanctifying of the church, but the actual presence of the Lady of Lament herself. All Andrite holy water comes from the ocean, and those who convey the water from sea to church on pilgrimage are held in great esteem among the Andrite faithful. The aspergillum takes the traditional shape of a spherical vessel set at the end of a long handle, with holes bored into the top to allow water to flow outward when the item is flicked. More uniquely, the shaft has been carved to look as though barnacles cling to it, and the vessel at the end has been made to resemble the moon palafa. Salt appears to have crusted in long wisps that wind around the object. Cool. Alright, so now we have to leave. We're gonna fight people.
My eyes are peeled.
Probably. I'd actually rather not fight anyone. I'd rather just leave. Chamber of Tears. So we need to go this way then. Through here and around. Open the gates of doom. Like this said, hopefully don't run into any of them on the way out. I'm just going to go upstairs. And hopefully we won't run into any of them. Down this way, yeah. Hug in that corner. Ooh, the Abbot's Quarters. We didn't go in there, did we? No. It's not even completely filled out, right? Let's go in there. Yeah. Down the long hallway. Maybe that opened when we finished the battle? I'm not even sure. Use the High Abbot's Key. Okay, the key, which we just got off in there. Cool. Nice. This is where the goodies are held. Push of Barring Death's Door and Major Endurance. Trap.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Disarmed. Oh, wait. It did it again. Ugh. I can't open it. You know, totally bugged. Scroll of Moonwell. Giftbringer Eden. Yeah, we have those. Moonwell. I hate that. Now we can never see what was inside that cool chest. Could have been a +5 sword of awesomeness, you know what I mean? This looks like it... Like you can leave from here. Wait. Hold up. There's a... Top of the Abbey. We can't go there? Huh. So let me just save and load. See if that works. Because I want to get in that. That might be required. Let's make a new save. Nope. We can't select it. Okay, I've reloaded. We'll try it again. I've reloaded from the autosave.
Time to see and not be seen.
Hmm? That's settled.
Oh. See, I need to click it right after, I guess? Crap.
That's settled.
Got it. Okay, good. You have to click it right away, I guess. Wonder what was in that other chest that bugged out. Journal of the High Abbot. This volume appears to serve many functions. There are notes in it detailing schedules and routines at the Abbey. There are favorite passages from Andre texts, annotated with personal insights. There are also descriptions of dreams. Many seem purely symbolic, but one entry is of interest. It had been long since I dreamt of my rising. Yet now, with another rising soon upon us, this is the fifth time in a week. Perhaps channeled here, I can put it to rest. I am walking through the halls of silence. I feel eyes on me from all sides. Angry, vengeful eyes. I arrange the panels and curl my hands into the sign of the tide. The right as the wave, the left tracing the crescent moon with my two outer fingers. The way opens to me. Okay, they specifically said it, although we didn't need to know it. Because we read his soul. I climb the steps and Andre's witness is installed there, the old aspergillum set to operate the valves. I use it like a lever and the water rises. There are angry shouts, and when I cover my ears, they are louder still. But the water continues upward, far past where it should. I climb as high as I can, but I feel it icy on my feet. Then it is over my head, and I cannot breathe. Suddenly I am outside the reliquary, looking at the veil of tears. The witness is in my hand, and the veil parts for it. I step through to the one place in the abbey I feel protected. Only when I pass inside I come out in total darkness. I call for help. I'm shouting, screaming for help. There is no answer. I stop. I sit there in the dark, waiting for what seems like ages. Then I realize I don't know who I am. Yeah. You have forgotten. I restored. I don't have that thing. So I'm guessing we can't go up there yet. Is there anything here? No. Yeah, they open both ways, these doors. Interesting. Off to the reliquary! Reliquary, how do you say it? It is there. Pretty interesting area. I would rest, but we have no more. You know, there's one outside, so if we need it, I'm pretty sure there's one outside in the grounds of the abbey, which they refer to as the abbey on the map. So let's quick save. And sneak.
My eyes are peeled.
And peel our eyes. Ouch. Oh, wow. Oh, interesting. Cool. The Veil of Tears. Hmm. What's in here? A pearl and 3 turquoises. Anything around the other side? We can walk down here. Huh. Nothing I want there. A little barrel at the end. Oh, yay! Camping supplies! And lockpicks. Hooray! There's another one, I think, around here or something? I'm not sure. At that point, I could only take 1 out of 2. I don't exactly recall where it was. Somewhere around here. An exceptional poleaxe and a fine quarterstaff. I'll take them both. Is there anything in here? No. Okay, I guess we just... I didn't even click that. What's this? Looking at a skull. Huh. The biggest eyeless thing ever. Of course, still sneaking. Always sneak. I heard that. Find Brigandine. Oop. Oh, the reliquary is up there, okay. We came from there. Okay. Hmm. So if that's there, then what's this way?
Yes.
Huh. When did I select just you? I must have clicked on him by mistake. So what's that way? Oh. This goes into... Wait, I can't see because it's... Oh, the Halls of Presence that way. Okay.
I guess the rest of the giant skeleton should have been our first clue.
Huh. The reliquary appears to contain only a single relic, the skull of an immense being. Somewhere in this enclosure is the means by which Kaoto meant to call off the eyeless. I guess through that. Jaw. The cracks on this jawbone suggest that a forceful blow separated it from its skull. What could hurt something like this? Huh. You know, I'm really curious where this goes. Before we advance any further. Oh, this is where we couldn't go. Now we can go. Huh. Okie doke.
Slowly now.
You see what? If we select this, lodged between rows of crystalline rock, a large fragment of metal protrudes. It looks as though it might be possible to pry it loose. Let's leave it for now. Let's explore first.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Judging by the distance to the nearby skull, a tremendous force separated this vertebrae from the rest of its giant body. Can you imagine how big this freaking thing is? Exceptional scale armor and a sapphire. The strange crystal formations of this rock, intact even after their collision against the thick bones of this giant skull, seem to radiate with a warmth of their own. Interesting. Warm stuff. That goes up to I do not know where. And that goes up. I don't know, I say go up first. I want to explore. The path ahead leads to the outskirts of the abbey. What would you like to do? Stay to continue exploring the area. We don't have a choice. It won't let us go. What about this one? We can go this one. Oh, we're here now. Okay. Okay, so apparently the only thing we can do is pull the stick out of that. And then maybe we can go that way. Or whatever this thing is. Oh wait, that's it. A large fragment of metal. Pull out the metal fragment. Who's that? At your touch, the splinter of metal begins to glow orange. Heat surges up your hands and arms and envelops you with such intensity, you feel as though you are melting down. The heat spreads to the world around you, turns it orange, and then yellow, and then white. The ground, the sky, everything around you drips in molten globs and begins to take shape beneath you as if in an invisible mold. This doesn't sound like a good thing to do. You and the shard are the last things to melt and fall, and your addition to the molten pool completes the shape of an immense hammer. The metal cools as quickly as it had heated. The handle is gripped now by two leathery hands, and the hammer is cocked back over a shoulder as broad and mottled as a hilltop. Did we bring the skeleton to life? The wielder whirls around and heaves the hammer, and you are flying upward for what seems like ages into an airless blackness above. That used to happen to me in Skyrim. Then I got hit by a giant, or Lord Karstag. Or King Karstag, right? As you spin, you catch glimpses of a rock large enough to be a moon. It is close, far too close to the world. The force of the impact shatters hammer and stone alike. Is this really happening? The rock is redirected outward, and a section of the front face is cleaved off and begins to fall, splintering apart at the cracks. In 100,000 fragments blossoming outward in all directions, debris showers the atmosphere, trailing smoke and fire. Below, land and sea are far off, but gradually rising up. Look to the sea. The largest of the fragments, wide as a city, barrels downward in a fiery cocoon. Its size reduces as the edges immolate, but it won't burn up in time. Cool. It lands silently in the distant ocean, sending a column of water skyward and radiating ripples that spread like wrinkles in fabric. Then the sound comes tearing up through the sky. It sounds like thunder. Look to the land. Features are becoming clearer by the moment as you streak toward the earth. You are lodged in an enormous boulder, falling among other fragments that heat and burst around you on all sides. Beneath you, snow-capped mountains rise up, dotted here and there by cities of stone and Adra. The impact will be the destruction of all of them. The shadow of your rock fragment is visible now, getting larger by the second. Well, what the hell can I do about it, right? You are moments away from striking the ground when a massive shape throws itself into your path. The last thing you hear sounds like another rumbling impact, but that isn't what it is. It is a chuckle, relieved, breathless. You hear two words. Made it. Everything goes dark. You open your eyes. The metal hammer fragment has come free, and you now hold it in your hands. It is warm to the touch. All that. The air around you is suddenly turbulent, spiteful. A cold, damp wind whips your face. Salt crystals collect in your nostrils and the creases of your eyes. The floor below you becomes blue-gray and glassy, churning and rolling, and when you fall, you crash through water. Violent waves hurl and spin you. Something slithers around your ankles, seizes you with incredible strength, drags you down into silty depths. Now, is this really happening, or am I seeing a vision or a memory of someone's past, or what? When the pulling stops, you are hovering at the center of an endless blue abyss. You can see neither surface nor floor. You seem to be facing downward, but there is no way to be sure. A voice sounds from everywhere at once, and the immense pressure wave of each utterance sends you reeling.
Deceitful wretch! Grave robber! You who dig for that which you did not bury, speak! Explain yourself and be judged!
It's Andra.